Coming up, we are going to have a look how easy it is to enroll Azure management services like monitoring, security center, and update management to your hybrid and multi-cloud resources. I'm here with Ryan Willis from the Azure management team, and we're going to have a look how you can leverage the Azure management resources for your hybrid and multi-cloud resources. Obviously, we have a couple of awesome Azure management services in the cloud for IT pros, developers, and everyone who needs them. Can you tell us a little bit more about these?
Yeah, definitely. So honestly, there's too many to talk about today, but let's focus on a couple of them. First off is Azure Update Management, which is really designed to help make sure that you are aware of which machines in your environment are missing updates and helps simplify when you actually go and schedule those updates to be installed. Secondly, we have Azure Monitor, which is really the foundation of so many of our Azure management services because it's responsible for collecting logs and performance data from your servers, which can be uploaded to log analytics workspaces and shared with other Azure services that can make recommendations and analyze the log data from those machines. And then lastly, we have Azure Security Center, which is kind of our overarching view of your security posture for everything we're aware of in Azure, including both the configuration of things like your servers and Kubernetes clusters, as well as higher level things like, did you configure role-based access control and network ACLs correctly?
So let's talk a little bit about some of the IT pro related tasks. I mean, I have seen many IT pros actually spending a lot of time doing update management for their servers. Doesn't matter if they're Linux or Windows servers, like update management is really a big challenge for our customers. And obviously we see that we in Azure, we have, as you mentioned, we have update management. And you just said that like with Azure Arc, we can actually extend this to our hybrid and multi-cloud resources.
You know, the real benefit of Azure Arc is that you see all of your resources in the Azure control plane, and it makes it easy to go and discover and onboard to services like update management, which can really simplify your life. And so to help explain, you know, what's going on here for an IT professional who's managing a server and potentially the updates on that as well, let's take a look at a demo of update management on Azure Arc. Okay, so I've opened up a Azure Arc server here, and you'll notice on the left we have an update management tab. If we navigate there, we will see the current status of updates on this machine. Now, if you haven't onboarded update management yet, this might be blank, but we'll provide instructions on how to actually get it all set up. But the idea here is in update management view, you'll be able to actually go and see all the updates that server might be missing and the severity and classification of those updates. And you can go and create schedules as well for when you want them to be updated. But if we head over to the multi-machine view, so if you're responsible for managing a group of servers, this is where it really starts to shine. And so here you'll see a list of all of the servers that update management is monitoring. Whether or not they are up to date, you'll see one of these servers is missing a security update, so it is marked as non-compliant, but the others are just missing some less important updates, so they have updates you could install, but they're deemed compliant. And so from here, we can actually go and create an update schedule. And the update schedule is when you actually want to go and push these updates out to a server. You might choose to do it as a one-off update if there's a particular set of updates you want to do, or if you want to maintain full control over which updates get pushed out. And you'll select which servers you need to update, as well as when you want the update to be pushed out. Now, if you want to do a more automated approach, you could also do a recurring update where, say, the third Sunday of the month, you can go and push out the updates to each of your machines. So the choice is yours, but the experience is the same. You can tell us how much time you allot for your update windows. If the updates take longer than that amount of time, we'll stop updating and just update the status with which updates are missing. And you'll be able to track the history and success rate of your update jobs right here in the update management experience.
Oh, this is awesome. Again, this is really like, I have helped and worked with so many IT administrators which needed to take care of managing these updates. And you obviously run into different scenarios where you probably want to schedule updates, like probably want to run like on a group of servers, you want to run it every Tuesday night, and the other one would be probably on Thursday night. And Azure Update Management really makes that so easy now. Another task where IT pros and developers obviously can benefit from is when it comes to monitoring, right? We all need monitoring solutions. We need to know how are our systems performing in terms of performance, but also when it comes to like troubleshooting, or when even when we know that there's probably like not enough disk space anymore and things like that. So I know that Azure Arc can help us here as well, right?
Yeah, definitely. So we give you a one-click experience to go set up the Azure Monitor Insights for VMs feature. And this gives you a wealth of information. So when we think of Azure Monitor, it's kind of two halves. There's the log collection half, where you can go and tell it, here's the logs that matter to me. Please collect them and let me query across them for a single machine or maybe a group of machines to find interesting events or track down a potential issue with that server. And then there's also insights, which are focused on being able to understand how this server fits into your network, as well as the performance counter information for its usage of resources. So let's take a look at a demo of this in action. So we're back here again, looking at our Azure Arc server. And on the left side now, if we head over to the Insights section, we'll be able to take a look at the data collected from this machine. And we start on this map page, which is the dependency graph of network connections, both in and out of this server. Now, my server doesn't have any inbound connections right now. It's still a dev test server, so it hasn't been doing much. But I can actually go and click any of these connections out and see how much traffic is going over them, how frequently they're connecting. And it's very useful information for understanding, like, is this machine being used by others if I were to potentially decommission it? Now, over here on the performance counter page, we can take a look at the current disk usage, CPU utilization, available memory, and you can even set an alert up such that if you start to run out of space or you find that over time you are using more CPU than you expected at certain times of day, you can set up a webhook or an email or a text message so that you get an alert when you have some servers that are potentially running out of capacity. Now, for these experiences, much like everything else we've talked about, there's also a multi-machine view. So in the Insights page, we are able to see across my entire resource group how all of my servers are doing. So if you have an application, it's distributed across multiple machines. You might want to go and figure out if one of them was potentially spiking and investigate where a potential bottleneck might be. So if we think about Kubernetes as well, it's just a similar experience for being able to monitor your Kubernetes clusters, but let's demonstrate how to actually onboard one. If I head over to the Azure Monitor page and go down to containers, you'll see a list of all those clusters which are currently monitored. But if I go to unmonitored clusters, I'll be able to see here that it knows there is an Azure Arc cluster that is not yet onboarded to Container Insights for Kubernetes. So if I click that and then go to enable it, I will be able to automatically deploy the necessary prerequisites to that Kubernetes cluster to go and start monitoring it. This is done through an extension model. So if we head over to the Kubernetes cluster and look at its extensions, you'll be able to see that this is currently in progress. And once it's done, it'll start collecting all the logs from the containers in that cluster and give you a similar insights into, you know, resource utilization and make it a lot easier for your developers to understand, you know, are the issues we're having potentially with our app related to the infrastructure or my application?
This now, like seeing all these monitoring information side by side, doesn't matter if they're running Azure or outside of Azure, this is really fantastic. And again, it's not just about servers. As you said, there's also Kubernetes clusters we can onboard. So we can really get that whole view of everything which is going on in our environment. So that is pretty cool. I also want to quickly highlight one point you showed at the beginning is the log analytics part, which is obviously very great. I cannot just get like performance logs, I can also get auditing logs and security logs, right? And I know that we can also leverage these logs even further, right? Using, for example, Azure Security Center.
Absolutely, yeah. So if you use Azure Security Center or Azure Sentinel, these tools can plug into the log data and they will actually tell log analytics which logs they need to collect in order to provide you recommendations about the security of your systems. And then they will automatically analyze them and provide really useful insights. For example, detecting unsuccessful logon attempts to your server. And they have their own logic to be able to throw that into an alert. Or if you're looking from the security operator point of view with Azure Sentinel, you know, you can create your own queries on this data and get a deep understanding of the audit events and security events that are coming out of all of your machines right from the Azure portal using a very easy to use Gusto query language.
So can you show us a little bit more about Security Center?
Yeah, let's go take a look actually. All right, so we're back here in the Azure portal looking at the Security Center page. And this is really your hub for everything you need to know about the security of your resources that are registered in Azure. The basis of this is really the secure score. It's a single number you can look at and get an understanding of how am I doing on important configurations that could impact the security of my environment. But we can also look at things like regulatory compliance. So if we click here, you can opt into a variety of different regulatory standards where there's predefined policies and checks in place so that we can provide you information about your adherence to the controls specific to each of those baselines. If you don't have a particular one in mind, we have a great Azure security baseline you can start with. And you'll see for each of these items that we are able to measure your compliance across all your resources. Now there's also Azure Defender. This is an optional component of Azure Security Center that provides really deep analytic insights into what is happening with all that log data. So we were just talking about, you know, being able to throw alerts when there are malicious logins on your machine. That is a capability of Azure Defender. But let's also look at vulnerability assessments. So there's obviously a huge potential to run software on your servers that have known vulnerabilities with CVEs or potentially outdated versions. And your Azure Defender for Servers license includes access to a vulnerability assessment solution that can go and analyze this for you and show it in a very easy to use interface. We also make it easy to onboard. So you'll see here, there's a couple servers that I have, Arc and Azure, that are not yet onboarded to the vulnerability assessment solution. So I can just go here and click through and say, look, I'd like to install this automatically on my server so that I can start getting these insights. And this is one of those things that's measured in that secure score. We want to make sure we are collecting data so that we can analyze and give you that best recommendation. And then when we head into the recommendation section, we can actually drill deep into the vulnerability assessments and take a look at what data came back for these servers. So we see here a list of software found on these machines with associated severities, and it's got everything from, you know, configurations of autoplay in Windows to outdated versions and known vulnerable software that's installed on our servers.
Now, this is fantastic. I mean, like the sheer power we can offer here, not just in terms of tooling, but also the data we are having from like attacks against our infrastructures and our services. We basically gather all that data and put that in our threat intelligence and actually give that to our customers when they run Azure. And now with Azure Arc, we also giving it the same technology and making it available, these services available for them, even if they run outside of Azure. And I think that is pretty cool. If people want to learn more about this, like you showed us a couple of different operational tasks, like in terms of update management, you showed us monitoring how developers and IT pros can leverage that, as well as when it comes to security, we have Azure Security Center and like we can leverage Azure Sentinel as well. So where would people go to learn more about this?
Yeah, so the best place to start is probably the Microsoft docs. So we have docs for each of these individual services, as well as some information about it in the individual Arc pages as well, with regards to how they tie in with Azure Arc. But you'll also find some examples in the Azure Arc Jumpstart site, ready to use configurations that already have like the monitoring agent deployed for you. And of course, you know, there's also going to be some great videos on all of our tech community sites and blogs that can help you get started with unique and potentially interesting combinations of these features.
Thank you very much, Ryan. This was really helpful. And for those who are watching, if you're working in a hybrid cloud environment or multi-cloud environment, make sure you check our cloud adoption framework and our Azure Architecture Center to find out more.